So yesterday we have started a new topic, that is Bedford codes, which comes under code structures, which produces longitudinal lines in the fabric. And we have already covered main characteristics of the Bedford design and its classification. These weaves produce longitudinal warp lines in the cloth with fine sunken lines between. And these sunken lines are produced due to pair of plane ends. Two ends are working in plane order and they are producing a depressed or sunken portion in the fabric throughout the length. And that's why we are calling them fine sunken lines. And these sunken lines are separating these longitudinal warp lines, which are resulting in a code structure. There are two types of Bedford code according to their face, which weave we are using on the face. If you are using plain weave, it will give plain face. If you are using twill weave, it will give twill face. And accordingly, it is named as plain face and twill face Bedford code. Then we have taken steps of construction for plain face Bedford code, in which PPR is fixed. That will remain 4, and EPR varies according to width of code. Means how many code ends we are taking in one code structure. That will decide ends per repeat. So we have taken.
Sir, voice break ho raha hai, sir.
Voice break ho raha hai. Sabhi ko problem aa rahi hai. Kajal.
Yes, sir.
आवाज ब्रेक की प्रॉब्लम सबको आ रही है
क्या? Yes, sir, voice break.
Due to network issue.
Network
थोड़ा अनस्टेबल हो रहा है, वीक नेटवर्क है आज इस वजह से. So, should we continue or not? Should we continue the class?
Sir, continue.
Okay. थोड़ी देर कंटिन्यू करते हैं. अगर स्टिल प्रॉब्लम एग्जिस्ट देन वी विल एंड द क्लास एंड वी विल शेड्यूल इट आफ्टर लंच.
Yes, sir.
We'll try for few minutes. If it works properly, then only we will continue the class. Otherwise, we will schedule the class after lunch, around 3 or 4. Okay. If there is no other class scheduled by any other lecturers, then we will schedule around 3 o'clock afternoon. So this example we have taken to understand construction of Bedford code in 12x4 by following each step, so that we can easily understand one by one all the steps, and then we can construct finally the design here. So for this, first we have taken the arrangement, and that I have cleared already. So you have understood the arrangement. It is one cutting end, which is having plane view, so known as plane ends. These four are the face ends, which are producing code structure. So they are also known as code ends. Again, pair of plane ends, and then code ends. And one plane, 1 plus 1, this is becoming pair of plane ends. So 2 plus 4, they are arranged in a symmetrical manner. It becomes 1 plus 4 plus 2 plus 4 plus 1, which is shown here in the diagram. And then because cutting ends are having interlacing order of plane, so we have indicated plane view, one up, one down, then next end starting with one down, one up, then again one up, one down, and then one down, one up. That is first step. Then in the second step, we are trying to produce code structure. So we are working only on the code ends or face ends. So on first two picks of the first code and last two picks of the second code, we are indicating floats, where the picks are floating at the back. Here the pick number 1 and pick number 2 are floating at the back on all these four picks. And here pick number 3 and 4 are floating at the back on these last two picks. So alternate coat structure will be produced in the fabric. And this is empty area where we have to insert the weave according to face of the weave. And because here we are using plain face, so in this area, plain weave will be indicated. The only thing, the only point we have to consider at the time of indication of plain weave, that the marks of the plain weave which we are inserting here should match with the already inserted mark of plain ends. So here it is one up, so we have to start this with one down, and then one up, one down, like that we can indicate the marks of plain weave in this area and this area. And in this way, we complete construction of Bedford coat design like this. Then we have taken draft for this, in which we are considering only one point, the heels, which the ends which are working in plain order are passing through first two heel frames, and then coat ends from the remaining heel frames. And then the lifting plan is constructed with the help of this design and draft, as we have taken many examples. So you can construct the lifting plan by yourself. Then I have taken the most important part here, which is known as sectional diagram. And how the sectional diagram is constructed, that I have shown you in the last class. This sectional diagram is cut through the warp. So warp ends are indicated in circles, small, small dots, first end, second end, third end, fourth end, fifth end, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10th, 11th, 12th. And the respective positions are joined with the design also, end number one, end number two, end number three, like this. Now what we have to do, first we have to arrange the ends in their suitable plane. They are not in same plane, because the structure is in such a manner, the for Bedford coat weaves, that few ends are lowering from the normal surface of the fabric. Those are known as sunken ends. So they are depressing from the normal plane. So humne usko niche ki taraf yahan par liya hai, all the plane ends ko, ek hi line ke andar. And then, because here we have a floating weave, so it is raising gradually and then depressing gradually, raising and falling gradually. So here we have four ends. So humne isko four ko is tarah se arrange kiya ki pehle ye gradual raising portion dikha raha hai, and then gradually lowering dikha raha hai iska. Similarly here, gradually rise and gradually lower. So in this way, we first indicate these dots which are indicating end number 1 to 12 in this design, and they are arranged in this particular manner only. After arranging the ends in this manner, then we will indicate the interlacing order of the picks, pick number 1, pick number 2, pick number 3, and pick number 4. Here we have taken pick number 1. Kal maine aapko alag color lekar ke samjhaya tha. Again, I will repeat. Pick number 1 is here. So, yahan aap dekhiye pick number 1 ka kya interlacing order hai. Because this is upside and this is downside in the sectional diagram. Upar ki taraf hai, that is upside. Niche ki taraf hai, that is downside. Face side of the fabric and back side of the fabric. Humne yahan isko start kiya. End number 1 yahan dekhiye pehle interlace, pick number 1 ka interlacing. First five ends per ye down hai, because here we have marks. Marks means warp is up, means weft is down. So weft is continuously down on first five. So humne yahan se start kiya isko. It is down, 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 down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tak down hai. Phir 6 par ye up ho raha hai. To hum yahan 6 ke upar इसको ऊपर की तरफ नीचे ले जाएंगे, एंड देन इट इज प्लेन ऑर्डर. थोड़ा सा ये थिकनेस ज्यादा है इसकी. इन दिस वे आफ्टर फाइव इट इज वन अप वन डाउन. इन दिस वे वी विल शो द इंटरलेसिंग ऑफ फर्स्ट पिक. सिमिलरली इंटरलेसिंग ऑफ सेकंड पिक, थर्ड पिक एंड फोर्थ पिक कैन बी इंडिकेटेड इन दिस मैनर, एंड देन यू विल बी एबल टू कंप्लीट द सेक्शनल डायग्राम. So here you can see the picks are floating at the back like this. It is floating at the back. And in the next code, it is interlacing in plain order. Similarly, second pick will float at the back and then interlace in plain water just opposite of this, because here it is starting with one up, second end. So second end will move like this. Then it is continuously down for five, and then it is up, just opposite of that. जो previous था उसका opposite हो जाएगा like this. So you can see the first two picks are floating at the back in first chord structure, and then they are interwoven in plane view in the next chord structure. So on the face we are getting a plane view. Similarly, third and fourth will interweave in plane order in the first part and will float at the back in the second part. And also here in this structure, in this area, you will get a plane face. So this area and this area, which is on the face of the fabric, they are showing or they are indicating plane weave. And that's why this face of the fabric is known as plane face, because on the face, plane weave is appearing in the fabric. That's why plain, it is known as plain face Bedford chord structure. So now I think it is clear, sectional diagram. We are taking another example here. Plain face Bedford chord in 16 cross 4. There is only one change we are doing, that is EPR we are changing. EPR is always fixed for plain face structures. So it is 4. And here we are changing EPR. In the previous example, we have taken 12. Here we are taking 16. So the arrangement will get changed. First select a size 16 cross 4 for design. Then arrangement will be decided by taking cutting ends 2 plus 2, that is 4, and face end 16 minus 4, because 16 is EPR. So 16 minus 4, that is 12. So arrangement of the ends, here we have 12 chord ends or face ends and 4 cutting ends. So arrangement will remain same, cutting 2, but chord ends will get changed because 12 can be divided by 2 and we will get equal width chords. 6 and 6, but here you can change. Here you can go for 8, and here you can go, you can take 4 also. So in that case, we will get unequal chord structures in the fabric. But when you are taking 6, 6, you will get equal chord structure of equal width. And then again, it is symmetrically arranged by taking 1 plus 6 plus 2 plus 6 plus 1, and that is indicated here. This is one plane end, cutting end. Then 6 chord ends, one plane, two plane, pair of plane ends, then 6 chord, and then one plane end. In this way, first we indicate the arrangement of the ends just above the design. Then we start construction of design in steps. So first we are indicating marks of plane weave on all the cutting ends or plane ends. So this is first cutting end, one up, one down, second cutting end, one down, one up, third, one up, one down, and the last, one down, one up, one down, one up. So first step is indicate the plane weave on all the cutting ends. Then on first and second pick, in the first chord, indicate the floats, all the crosses, 6 crosses and 6 crosses. Similarly here, 6 crosses and 6 crosses in the alternate chord on third and fourth pick. So in this way, we are indicating the floats, because weft is this first and second weft is floating at the back. Here third and fourth pick is floating at the back, which is shown here by these crosses. And then in the remaining area, we have to indicate plane view, which should be properly fit with the already indicated marks of plane view of cutting ends. So one up, it is one up. So it will start with one down, one up, one down, one up, one down, one up, and then one down. It is down, so it will start with up, down, up, down, up, down. Similarly here, it is down, so it will start with up, and it is up, so it will start with down. And in this way, we can complete the design, which is a plain face Bedford chord in 16 cross 4. Draft will be constructed in the similar manner. First end from first hill, then next cutting end from second hill, then next cutting end because similar with first, so first hill, and then last one is similar with this one, and this is passed through second, so this will also pass through second. So first two hills are for plane V, and then this is a new interlacing order, so it will require another hill. So second ke baad isko third se pass kiya. This is again different. Fourth hill, this is same as this. Third hill, fourth hill, third hill, fourth hill. This code structure requires two hill frames, so we have given third and fourth. Next code structure is having different interlacing order and requires two hill frames, 5 6 5 6 5 6, and you can construct lifting plan from the given design in draft just by following the principle of drafting. And here the denting plan is shown. As I have mentioned in the steps, denting plan is constructed or can be constructed by indicating plane ends from the same hill frame. So these two plane ends from same dent of reed, so we are indicating them in the same line. It means they are passing through same dent. Similarly, this cutting end will be from the same dent, but before that we have to indicate these chord ends, and chord ends generally we pass through two dents. So if here we have six chord ends, then three from this and three from this, three from one dent, three from one dent. Divide the chord ends by two and decide the denting order. So yahan six hai, to hum yahan pe 3 3 kar denge. Previous example mein four the, to denting order wahan pe hum inka 2 2 kar denge. In this way chord ends are having their denting order, and again plane end, plane are passing through same. Similarly here 3 and 3, so we are having a irregular type of denting order for this Bedford chord designs. So in this way you can indicate design, draft, lifting plan and denting plan. And in the similar manner you can construct sectional diagram for this design, as we have constructed sectional diagram for 12 cross 4 in the previous example. One more example with slight variation I am taking here, plain face Bedford chord in 14 cross 4. So in 14 cross 4 the face ends, the chord ends will be 10, and if we take equal width of the chords, then in first chord 5, in second chord 5, which is odd number. In previous two cases chord ends were in even number. So agar ye even hai, to what will be the method, what will be the step we will follow? And if it is odd number, then there will be a slight change in the method of construction. Wo chota sa change hoga, because it is odd number, so yahan par hame keval plain view ka जो कटिंग एंड्स है, हम यहाँ वन अप से स्टार्ट कर रहे थे और ये वन डाउन से स्टार्ट कर रहे थे. इसमें हमें ये करना है कि वन अप से अगर ये स्टार्ट हो रहा है, इस कोड के जो पहले वन अप है तो नेक्स्ट भी वन अप रहेगा, और इस कोड स्ट्रक्चर के पहले वन डाउन वन अप है तो यहाँ भी वन डाउन वन अप रहेगा. केवल प्लेन एंड का जो कमेंसिंग है, इन दैट वी हैव टू कंसिडर दिस पॉइंट कि यहाँ वन अप से स्टार्ट किया. प्रीवियस एग्जांपल्स में हमने इसको वन डाउन से स्टार्ट किया एज यूजुअल प्लेन में जैसा होता है, बट यहाँ दोनों जो एंड्स हैं, दोनों बाउंड्रीज पे एंड्स हैं कोड के, वो दोनों सिमिलर रहेंगे. तो ये वन अप से स्टार्ट किया तो ये भी वन अप से स्टार्ट होगा, और ये वन डाउन से स्टार्ट हुआ तो ये भी वन डाउन से स्टार्ट होगा. दिस इज ओनली फॉर द केसेस व्हेन ओड एंड्स आर देयर इन द कोड स्ट्रक्चर, एंड देन इंडिकेट द प्लेन इन द सिमिलर मैनर. That will fit with the already indicated marks. और इसलिए हमने यहाँ पे change किया. Otherwise, अगर आप यहाँ one down one up से start करेंगे तो ये plane view के marks properly fit नहीं हो पाएंगे. ये marks properly fit हो सके already indicated marks के साथ में, इसलिए हमने यहाँ पर ये एक change किया है कि this, क्योंकि यहाँ odd है and plane view repeats on even number, तो यहाँ हमें even number चाहिए. यहाँ even नहीं है तो हम क्या कर रहे हैं, प्लेन एंड्स का ऑर्डर चेंज कर रहे हैं. व्हेनेवर यू हैव ओड नंबर ऑफ थ्रेड्स फॉर कोड स्ट्रक्चर, देन यू हैव टू डू दिस स्लाइट चेंज इन द स्टेप ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शंस. सो दिस अ स्मॉल पॉइंट वी हैव टू कंसीडर, व्हिच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज इफ यू आर टेकिंग दिस टाइप ऑफ कोड स्ट्रक्चर, दिस टाइप ऑफ साइजेस, देन इफ यू आर इंडिकेटिंग इट इज वन डाउन वन अप, देन द होल डिजाइन विल बी इनकरेक्ट. The next variation of this plane face, means plane face Bedford cord, can be modified by taking this cord structure on alternate picks. In the previous case, what we were doing, the cord structure we were indicating on first two picks and third and fourth pick, means in pair, two picks here and two picks here. But in the next case, we are not taking pair of picks. Instead of that, we are arranging them on alternate picks. So alternate picks pe jab arrange karna hai, to again there will be slight changes. जो अब जो भी हम करने जा रहे हैं डिजाइंस, जो हमने पहले बेसिक मेथड लिया है, उन्हीं की स्टेप्स में थोड़ा सा चेंज करके, थोड़ा सा वेरिएशन करके, वी विल कंस्ट्रक्ट द डिजाइन। यहाँ पर भी वही रहेगा, व्हेन वी आर इंडिकेटिंग ऑन अल्टरनेट पिक्स, तो जो प्लेन है वो सिमिलर स्टार्ट होगा, दोनों फर्स्ट कोड के लेफ्ट में और राइट में जो प्लेन एंड है, दे विल स्टार्ट, देयर कमेंसिंग विल बी सेम, मीन्स इफ इट इज स्टार्टिंग विद वन अप, दिस विल ऑल्सो स्टार्ट विद वन अप, देन ये नेक्स्ट कोड स्ट्रक्चर है, इसमें ये वन डाउन वन अप से स्टार्ट हो रहा है और ये भी वन डाउन वन अप से स्टार्ट होगा। दैट इज वन चेंज। अनदर चेंज, टू कॉन्जिक्यूटिव पिक्स नहीं लेकर के हम एक पिक छोड़ के फिर एक पिक पर फ्लॉट लेंगे, अगेन वी विल लीव वन पिक एंड देन नेक्स्ट पिक, सो दिस इज ऑल्टरनेट पिक। फर्स्ट हमने लेफ्ट लीव कर दिया, सेकेंड पे हमने फ्लॉट इंडिकेट किया, थर्ड को हमने लीव किया, फोर्थ के ऊपर हमने फ्लॉट इंडिकेट किया, और यहाँ हमने फर्स्ट को लीव किया तो यहाँ पर हम फर्स्ट पर, क्योंकि ये उसका अपोजिट होता है, तो फर्स्ट पिक पर फ्लॉट, सेकंड लीव, थर्ड के ऊपर फ्लॉट एंड फोर्थ को हम लीव कर दें। इन दिस वे विद दिस स्लाइट चेंजेस वी विल कंस्ट्रक्ट द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ बेडफोर्ड कोर्ट डिजाइन एंड देन इंडिकेट प्लेन व्यू इन द रिमेनिंग एरियाज। यहाँ भी प्लेन व्यू इंडिकेट करेंगे, यहाँ भी प्लेन व्यू, यहाँ भी प्लेन व्यू और यहाँ भी प्लेन व्यू इंडिकेट करना है। बट वन थिंग वी यू विल ऑब्जर्व इन दिस डिजाइन कि जो प्लेन के मार्क्स हैं दे आर नॉट फिटिंग विद दैट वन एंड दैट इज लिमिटेशन ऑफ ऑल्टरनेट दिस न्यू मॉडिफिकेशन विच इज टेकिंग प्लेस ऑन ऑल्टरनेट पिक्स। यहाँ पे प्लेन व्यू कम्प्लीटली फिट नहीं होगा। आप देखिए यहाँ वन अप है, अगेन वन अप आ रहा है। अगर यहाँ आप वन डाउन से स्टार्ट कर देंगे तो यहाँ वन अप से स्टार्ट करेंगे तो इस पिक में आएगा, तो एक तरफ इस पिक में आएगा, एक तरफ इस पिक में सिमिलर मार्किंग आएगी प्लेन की। And that is limitation that we cannot do for this. Any we cannot do anything for this. So we will indicate in this manner the plane view on the remaining picks. Here first and third, here second and fourth. And in this way, we will complete the design of Bedford cord on alternate picks. The draft can be constructed in a similar manner. First hill, these two plane ends from first hill, these two plane ends from second hill. Then this is from third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Lifting plan can be constructed by given design and draft. And sectional diagram in the similar manner, indicating configuration of all the four picks along with the ends, which are indicated in a special manner here, according to their plane in the fabric. Us fabric mein kya unka surface par niche ki taraf hai ya upar ki taraf hai, jo humne wahan liya hai. Previous example mein, as it is, it will be indicated here. So this example is same as first example we have taken. The only difference is in that case we were taking simple plane face, ordinary plane face Bedford cord, but this is not ordinary. This is arranged on alternate picks. So this is one type of modification we can do with Bedford cord structure. They can be arranged alternate on alternate picks. That is one modification. Another modification we can do with Bedford cord structure is wedded Bedford cord weaves. We can produce, we can introduce some of the wedding ends. So thick wedding ends are introduced, which lie between the rib face cloth, जो plain face जो हमने दिखाया है, उसमें उसके और weft slots जो है underside उन दोनों के बीच में thick wedding ends are introduced. Which lie between the plain face cloth and the weft slots on the underside to give greater prominence to the cords. Or its main purpose, jo hai, the main object of introducing wedding ends or wedding threads is to increase the prominence of the structure. So here we have a cord structure. So if we want to enhance the prominence of cord structures, then we will use wedding ends, and if we are using wedding ends, we are introducing wedding ends. That structure is termed as wedded Bedford chord structure. How wedding ends are introduced? That is most important thing. They are following a particular pattern. So that pattern is wedding ends remain up. These ends remain up where the picks float at the back. जहां पर पिक्स बैक साइड में फ्लोट कर रहे हैं वहां तो वेडिंग एंड्स अप रहेंगे एंड वेडिंग एंड्स रिमेन डाउन वेयर द पिक्स वीव इन प्लेन ऑर्डर. जहां पर पिक्स प्लेन ऑर्डर में वीव करते हैं वहां पर ये उनके नीचे की तरफ रहेंगे. जहां पर पिक्स नीचे की तरफ फ्लोट कर रहे हैं, पीछे की तरफ फ्लोट कर रहे हैं, बैक साइड में उनके ऊपर होंगे और जहां पर प्लेन फेस बन रहा है उनके नीचे होंगे. So that they will not appear on the face of the fabric. Fabric mein wo dikhai nahi denge. They will remain between these two, these picks. And because they are underneath, they are below the plain face. So jitna hum coarseness lenge in threads ka, wedding ends ki jitni coarseness lenge, jitna inka coarser count lenge, wo utna hi mota hoga aur wo uska prominence ko badhayega. So according to required prominence, we are deciding thickness of the wedding ends. How they are introduced in the design, that can be seen with this example. Here we are taking a plain face wedded Bedford chord in 14x4, and this is based on 12x4. जो हमने first example लिया था 12x4, you can see here, just forget about these two ends which are indicated by W. W means wedding, C means cutting, F means face, W means wedding ends. इन वेडिंग एंड्स को अगर आप छोड़ दें एक बार के लिए, जस्ट फॉरगेट अबाउट दिस टू एंड्स, देन यू विल सी द स्ट्रक्चर दैट इज सिमिलर विद प्लेन फेस बेडफोर्ड कोड इन 12x4, जो हमने फर्स्ट एग्जांपल लिया है. अब यहाँ पे हमें क्या करना है, अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर रिक्वायरमेंट वी कैन इंसर्ट वन और टू वेडिंग थ्रेड्स. इस डिजाइन में हमने पहले कोड स्ट्रक्चर में वन और दूसरे में भी वन वेडिंग एंड इंट्रोड्यूस किया, एंड वी आर फ्री फॉर दैट. वी कैन इंट्रोड्यूस वन और टू, but generally we are not exceeding, we are not going more than two. So here we are taking first one in first chord structure, one in that. So yahan aap isko khali chhod dein pehle, in first step pehle plane view indicate kar dein, fir ye floats indicate kar dein, keval is end ko, is line ko khali chhod dein aur yahan pe is line ko khali chhod ke, as it is plain face Bedford chord structure aapko banana hai in dono line ko khali chhodne ke baad. Aur fir kya karna hai, यहां पर जहां की फ्लॉट फ्लोटिंग है बैक की तरफ, ये दीज पिक्स आर फ्लोटिंग एट द बैक, ये सेक्शनल डायग्राम में आप देख सकते हैं, एंड दीज पिक्स आर फ्लोटिंग एट द बैक थर्ड एंड इज थर्ड एंड फोर्थ. तो इनके ऊपर और इनके नीचे ये आएगा, यानी कि बीच में कहीं इसको इंडिकेट करना है इन द सेंटर लाइक दिस. तो यहां अगर यहां तो सेंटर में इंडिकेट कर देंगे, यहां पे क्या होगा, यहां ये अप रहेंगे जहां पे ये फ्लॉट बैक साइड में है और जहां पे प्लेन व्यू है वहां पर ये डाउन रहेंगे. सो टू अप टू डाउन, two down, two up. So one more hill frame is required for this. One more hill frame is required for this. So two more hill frames will be required. So in this case, we will require 8 hill frames. And they are dented along with the same this chord ends. इनके लिए अलग special dent नहीं लेते हैं. जिनमें chord ends को pass कर रहे हैं, उसी के through इनको भी हम pass कर देते हैं. In this